Hello students, good morning. Welcome to your English class. Although we have done with the course of April and May in both reader and in grammar, but we should revise this chapter in grammar to do the revision work from it. Okay, so we have first chapter as sentences in grammar. What is the meaning of sentence? Let's have the definition first. A group of words that makes a complete sense is called a sentence, which means शब्दों का ऐसा समूह जिससे कोई अर्थ या मतलब निकलता हो उसे हम sentence कहते हैं. Okay? इसका मतलब क्या हुआ? What does it mean? Let's try to understand this through these examples. Okay? As like when I say am teacher I, does it make any sense? क्या इसका कोई मतलब है? Am teacher I what? No, there is no sense at all in these words, a group of words. Let's take the another. A song sing. What song? What sing? There is again no sense. Okay? There is no information. We Indians. It is also doesn't make any sense. Okay? Dev running road. There is no sense at all. So all these words, as like all these four words don't make any sense. इनसे कोई मतलब नहीं निकलता है. ये सिर्फ क्या है? They are just a group of words. और ऐसे group of words जिनसे कोई मतलब नहीं निकलता हो उन्हें हम sentence नहीं कह सकते. Okay? Because sentence हम उसी ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स को बोलेंगे जिनसे कोई सेंस निकलता हो. एज वी हैव रीड द डेफिनेशन दैट अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स दैट मेक्स अ कंप्लीट सेंस इज कॉल्ड अ सेंटेंस. फॉर एग्जांपल्स, देव इज रनिंग ऑन द रोड. देव सड़क पे दौड़ रहा है. नाउ इससे सेंस निकला? हाँ, इट इज़ मीनिंगफुल. इसका कोई मतलब है, इससे अर्थ निकलता है. सो दैट्स वाई इट इज़ a sentence, because it makes a complete sense. Okay, second sentence, I am a student. मैं एक student हूँ. If I say I student am, does it make any sense? No. When I say I am a student, then it makes a complete sense. Okay, so here I am a student is a complete and meaningful and making a sense. That's why it is called a sentence. They sing a song. We are Indians. So these are the examples of sentences. Okay? Now, how we can say and how we can make a sentence to be meaningful? It should carry the parts of subject and predicate. And also, it contains a verb. Only in that condition, it could be a sentence. तो एक sentence कैसे बनेगा? किसी भी group of words में कोई भी sense कैसे निकलेगा? जब उस sentence में subject होगा, predicate होगा, साथ ही verb भी होगा. ठीक है? So for that, let's see what are the parts of a sentence. एक sentence में कितने part होते हैं? वो किन parts से मिलके बनता है? There are two parts of a sentence. Two parts of a sentence. The first one is subject. पहला क्या है? Subject. What is subject? The doer of the action. Remember that. The doer of the action is called subject. For example, Rohan flies a kite. Okay. Doer of the action से meaning, इसका क्या मतलब हुआ? Doer of the action यानी कि जो काम कर रहा है, जो person काम कर रहा है या कोई एक्शन कर रहा है वो उस सेंटेंस का सब्जेक्ट हुआ. ठीक है? फॉर एन एग्जाम्पल, रोहन फ्लाइज ए काइट. रोहन काइट यानी कि पतंग. रोहन पतंग उड़ाता है. हेयर हु इज़ फ्लाइंग ए काइट? रोहन. रोहन फ्लाइज ए काइट विच मीन्स हेयर रोहन इज़ डूइंग द एक्शन. रोहन एक्शन कर रहा है विच मीन्स रोहन इज़ द डूअर ऑफ द एक्शन हेयर इन दिस सेंटेंस. So that is why Rohan would be the subject in this sentence. Okay? So the doer of the action is called subject. Now what is the second part of a sentence? The second part of a sentence is called predicate. What is predicate? The action done by the doer. The action done by the doer is called predicate. तो predicate क्या है? जो action हो रहा है, जो doer वो action कर रहा है, जो काम हो रहा है, उसी को predicate बोलते हैं. Okay? और rest you can say that the rest part of the sentence other than the subject are called predicate. For an example, let's take the same example. Rohan flies a kite. Now here, Rohan flies a kite. Here Rohan is subject, correct? Now because who is doing the action? Rohan. So Rohan would be the subject. But what is the action? Action kya hai? That he flies a kite. Okay? So here, flies a kite would be the predicate. Okay? Would be the predicate here, flies a kite. Second sentence, respect your teachers. Here, in respect your teacher, when I tell you to respect your teacher, which means here you would be the subject. Okay? It is an imperative sentence, and in imperative sentences, the subject is always you. And it is hidden or implied. ठीक है, वो लिखा हुआ नहीं होता है बट वो अंडरस्टूड होता है कि जब भी हम ये बात बोलते हैं कि बड़ों की इज्जत करनी है, टीचर्स की इज्जत करनी चाहिए, रिस्पेक्ट योर टीचर्स, तो डैट मीन्स कि हम सामने वाले से ही बोलते हैं. तो सामने वाला क्या होता है? तुम, यू. ओके, सो यू वुड बी द सब्जेक्ट हेयर एंड रिस्पेक्ट योर टीचर्स वुड बी द प्रेडिकेट. ओके, सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट वॉट इज सब्जेक्ट एंड वॉट इज प्रेडिकेट. लेट्स हैव द revision quickly. That a group of words that makes a complete sense is called a sentence, and there are two parts of a sentence, subject and predicate. What is subject? The doer of the action is called subject, and the action done by the doer is called the predicate. Okay, so I hope you have understood. Now try to make sentences and it should be meaningful. Okay, I'll see you in next class. Thank you.